Hello friend, welcome back. In our previous video, I already convert our index.html template file to convert that things to our blade template. Okay, that means in our blade template, I already added that things on particular disposition. So that is our home. Okay, so now I want to convert this category page, that means this category.html, and here I want to convert it to our blade template. So for doing this, first of all, we have to actually open that category.html. So if you go to our exercise file, and in our template, that is a font template, so that is our category.html. First of all, I just open it with the sublink text. So that is actually our sublink text. So first of all, we have to actually find out our content part. That means this content part, because I already include our all that header. You can see header is the pretty much same, and CSS will be the same. I already included it. And also, and that is our footer part. Okay, so now from this position to our this position, that means here, so that will be our main content part. Okay, so that will be the dynamic. So for the reasons I have to find out that part, like I already included all that CSS, I already included the menu. Okay, you can see that is actually the menu. So we have to define our main content part. So that is actually the section, that is actually the braid clump and the section. This section, actually from this section, actually our content part for the category. So I just click on here. I just make the things minimize. Okay. So before the subscription. So like here, I already added our footer part before the subscription area. So we have to actually get all the things before that. So for now, I just want to minimize it. So there is also row, there is another Dave, there is another Dave, and there is another one. So that is the designation, there is a popular news, that is the side we get. And there is also, there is another reviews, most comment, okay. It's editor, and there is another part, there is also the another widgets. So here there is actually the subscription. So I already add that subscription section in our footer. So from here, okay, so I just cut that things from here. I just copy it and into this position, not here. I have to cut it from after that menu, and then so that is actually the section. Okay, so here I just copy that things from here, and now I want to create another page in our font folder. So here I just create another page, and I just click on the save as, and I just name it as a listing dot blade dot php. Okay, and here I paste our main content part for our category. So now into this page, we also have to update our this URL. Okay, that means this path. So I already did that type of work in our home page. Like here you can see there is an asset, then public font image, and then the images. So better I just copy it. Okay, I just copy it. I hope you can well understand about it, of what exactly the things you have to do. Like there is a public font, then image folder. So here there's after that asset, so that is actually the image, and then actually that image. So here I just paste that things on particular disposition. Right now I don't need that. Okay, because that is actually the static. I just copy all the things from our template area. So here there is also some of the images, so we have to actually all that make that path for the blade. Okay, so we also have to update that path. So that is for the one. So then there is another one, there is images. So here I just paste it. So that is the images. I just copy that images, and here the images root, and then the JPG. But now we don't need it. I just remove that things from here. And also there is another one we also have to update. So before I just copy. So I think you can well understand about it, what exactly the things you have to do. You have to actually make that path update. So here I just copy it, and here after that images, so that is actually the path. So I just copy it, okay. I just paste, and I just remove that things from here. So that's all that images, actually the right at 7.jpg. So better I just copy it, and here I just paste it, and also paste it, and also I just paste it on here. So I hope you can well understand about it, what exactly the things you have to do. As I told you, asset is the main root directory, then you have to go to the public, and then the font, and the images, and then actually the image name. Okay, so we have to update all that images. So I will do that work, and also there is your task. You will do that work, and after update all that URL, then I will come back again. So friend, I updated all that URL. Okay, I updated all that URL. So there is also the another one. I updated all that URL right now. Okay, so for the all that images. So better actually it may take a lot of the time. So better I just copy it and I just make one of the folder for you. Like if you go to the project and you know what templates, that is the exercise. So here I just create one of the page folder. So here I just create one of the folder and name it as a view all page. So here I just name it of the view all page, and into this position I just create one of the text file and I just name it as a listing. Listing.txt, and into this position I updated that. Okay, rather it should be very much helpful to you. So I already updated all that images on particular this position. So you just copy it and just paste that things in your page. Okay, so here I just added that things on particular this position. Hope it will help you a lot. It will actually reduce your time. So that is actually our listing page. I already updated it. So now we have to do, we have to extend our master, because in our master here I already defined the yield as a content, because this part will be the dynamic. So I also want to load that part in our this master page. So for doing this, what exactly we have to do? We have to do the things that I did on particular disposition. Okay, there is the extend, that font layout and the master, and here I just added the section. So I just copy it, and here I also assigned that things on particular disposition. And also we have to do, we have to end that section. So after that end, so here I just want to end it as a end section. Okay, so I just define that end section on here. So I hope you can well understand about it, what exactly the things I want to do. First of all, here I just extend that page in our master. So in our, it should be actually in our master part. Here I define one of the contain. And also I created one of the segment, one of the section as a content. That means this content part only will be loaded on particular disposition. Okay, so that will be the dynamic as I told you before. So that is the things I want to do on here. And now then what exactly we have to do? We have to now create one of the controller, and we also have to add some of the method. So for doing this, first of all, I want to create one of the controller. So that is our root directory, and here I have to define the CMD. And now I want to create one of the controllers. So we have to write down as a PHP artisan make and then controller. Okay, and I want to create one of the controller as a listing base controller. So this type of controller, so here I just click on the enter. So now our controller created successfully. So now if you go to this position, so now right now there is about, okay, so we don't need it, I remove it. There is a master, the home category. So which page will be the needed? I just say that things, that is header, there is a top, there is an index. Okay, so there is a home controller, there is a master. So now I already created another controller on particular disposition as a listing page. Okay, and here I want to do, here I want to create one of the method. Like first of all, I just define the public and then function, and I just create one of the method as index. So I already did that work in our home, like in our home controller, and here I assign one of the page as a font home. Okay, so now here I also do the same thing. So for now I just copy it, and here that means this position. So here I return the view and the font, that means in our font folder. Here I created the another page as a listing. So now here I just define that listing. So now we have to do, we have to create one of the route for this one, that means for the listing page. So here if you go to this position, so like I just copy it, okay, and here I just paste it. So now our URL will be listing. And here there is our controller name. So into this position, our controller name is the listing page controller. So here I just define that listing page controller. And into the listing page controller, I created one of the method as index. So here I created the method as index. And into the index method, here I return that to the view font folder and the listing page. Okay, so now it's perfect. So now if you want to access this, like I just click on the save all, and now that is our home. Okay, and now after that home directory, I just added the listing, and now if you click on the enter, yes, now you can see our header part will be the same, footer part will be the same, and into this middle position, that means into the center position, there's contained part. So that's only the contained part is now loading successfully. Okay, so that is our listing parts. Now it's totally dynamic. I just convert it to the from the HTML to now the blade PHP, and now here there is our footer part. So everything is now perfect on particular disposition. So here I successfully load our listing page, and now also they have the another page that is actually the single.html page. So in our next video, I will show you how can convert that single.html page to the blade. Okay, so then it will be very much interactive. So thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.